I don't know why I'm making these. I want to give advice, and maybe you can learn from my mistakes. That's it. Hello. So, since part one did really well, let's do a part two and actually tell you what my god-awful book was about. Be prepared to laugh. I do the BBG for some unknown reason. My main account is Bald Book Geek. All of the links and info down below. If you want to like and sub, go for it. So, where do we start with this? Okay, so please forgive if I'm not looking at the camera. I'm actually working right now. I'm doing some stuff. But the... Okay. Let's start with what the book was originally like, before they butchered it, and then I will talk about what it became. How's that one? Let's have some fun. First things first. I kind of got the page numbers wrong. I looked at the original manuscript. It's like just under 400 pages. But the actual story was set after the Roswell crash and decades after the survivors of several crashes that happened at the time hid in plain sight. They fled a dying world and crash landed on Earth and landed in places, and they hid in plain sight. During the Roswell crash, there was an artifact that was lost, a piece of genetic code. The genetic code ended up in possession of a family who just found it in the sand, and through the generations, this code ended up imprinting itself. And I want you to imagine something about this big, like an artifact made out of glass with a swirl in it that kind of looked like an orchid. We'll get to the orchids in a minute. And it imprinted itself on the first person to touch it because it was broken. And that genetic code got passed through the family and in the current descendant, a young woman in her 20s who has just graduated university. And this genetic code belonged to the race. And effectively, it was the knowledge of this dying world, the war, and the genetic code of someone that witnessed it all. And throughout her life, she's been haunted by nightmares and dreams. The government have been looking for this person for a long time, and through means that get explained in the book, they find her. That she ends up on the run and ends up being rescued by a group of the aliens hiding in plain sight on Earth. Matthias, one of the main characters, was not really a love interest. It was a platonic friendship between them, with maybe a hint of romance later on, but the romance was not the driving force behind the story. So, it was basically a political thriller from his perspective, and went from there, really. And it was kind of them going across America on the run and setting events into motion that would have been book two and book three. And there it is. I scored a publishing deal. I won a publishing deal. But this is what happened. They loved the characters and the concept, but they felt like they needed changes. And me being me, as I said in the first video, I didn't want to offend anyone or potentially alienate because it was a huge opportunity. And I agreed to these changes and I rewrote the book alongside an editor, and it was a disaster. The book was ripped apart and turned into a just under 200 page young adult novel that breezed over most of it and changed the narratives completely. The female character became the main focus of the story and her point of view. She was now a high school student, and it was still roughly the same backstory. She meets an attractive high school boy who she's never seen before. It was bad. And her family again found the artifact, but in this version of the story, the artifact looked like a crystal orchid because they thought it would be more visual. And they wanted the love story as the main focus. So it became more of a love story with aliens. It was basically Twilight with aliens. And they wanted a maybe love triangle, and one of the other characters was converted into that role. We do not talk about this. We do not... It's horrible. I will never name this book because it's got my real name on it. And I've also muted and removed the ability to put the name of the book in the comments, just so you know. It exists in a weird bubble, and it It was bad. It was genuinely bad. It was a disaster zone, and I regret it horribly. A lot of the depth and all of the sort of frills and the sort of... Think of it kind of a 24-like scenario. The book one took place over the course of 5 days, and all of that was turned, and then they go on the run, and the difference being, one of the big key differences was that in the original story, she was more thrown into this head first, not quite knowing what to do, how to deal with it, and what to deal with it. She didn't quite believe what was happening to her, and in this version, she was the published version. It became this, what's the word I'm looking for? It became she was far more eager. She knew what she wanted. She wanted to be there. She wanted to do this and do that. And it just didn't work. She wanted to run away from all her problems and, you know, be a not like other girls, but they stripped her of all personality. She was a blank slate to the point of frustration, if you want the honest truth. She was a blank slate character with no real personality, and they stripped this character, who was based on someone I know, from someone who was headstrong and driven to someone completely different. And despite going from a more passive role in the story and needing to be protected, and kind of the brains of the outfit, she became a lot of the key scenes were switched to her, and somehow she knew all this stuff, and they gutted the book to the point that it didn't bear any resemblance to what I originally created. There was nothing remotely similar, and it was disheartening, to say the least, on the subject. It was very, very... It was sad. It was absolutely sad. And I came out of it, and I remember thinking, this is not the book. Now, Orchids. I'm just, out of pure horror, I'm going to describe the book cover to you. A girl in a leather jacket with a badly photoshopped alien necklace on, holding a literal orchid flower in her hands, like an oversized one, Twilight style, with very, very similar text to the Twilight books. And then behind her in the black void was the very subtle outlines of some grey aliens that don't appear within the book at all. I was kind of soul destroyed by the time of it came out, and when we got to the end of it, it was a horrible experience, and it's one that I would never want to repeat. It left me very, very cold, and it made me realize that maybe I don't want this. I mean, it bore no resemblance to my original story. It had nothing really in there that even grounded it. And I agreed to all of it, and my God, do I regret it. I regret it horribly. I should have been more upfront. I should have just said stuff. I should have said no to these changes, but not wanting to alienate the people. Sitting next to me in my office, there's 3 boxes stacked up. 2 of those boxes have copies of this book in. Many of the copies I found on the internet and actively sought out and bought, I have destroyed. Like, I have actively seeked out to destroy them. And so far, I have destroyed 300 copies. I want to keep a few, but they don't exist anymore, and I want to keep it that way. It's embarrassing, and I'm embarrassed by the book. And I noticed a few people disliking the first video, and I don't know why, because I'm just being honest and telling the story of things that happened. And I think it does show a few publishers in a bad light. But you know what? Who cares at this point? Let's be honest. But no, I will say this. Stand by your decision, stand by your work, and don't do what I did. Because the cringe is real, and the whole situation left me very cold to it all. And I don't know how to process what happened there. But progressively, I am eradicating its existence off the internet. You cannot purchase this thing as an ebook. You cannot purchase this book. It does not exist, and it will never exist. Although, I do have plans. I want to maybe revisit the book at some point in the future, maybe, and go from, and see what happens. The rights are mine. I own the manuscript. I own the rights to it all. And we'll see. That's the operative word. Maybe I don't think I'll publish the edited version, but I would like to revisit the original and look at it again through new eyes. Because I've got the manuscript on my computer. I also have a physical print of it. That's a bonus, isn't it? So anyway, I will leave this here. My failings might be amusing, and I'm sure the people disliking my video are just listening to a guy moan. But you know what? I don't know why I'm making these. I want to give advice, and maybe you can learn from my mistakes. That's the operative word here.